हाँ, सो करंटली वी आर स्टडिंग अवर सिक्स्थ यूनिट, फाइनल यूनिट, दैट इज अनसर्टेनिटी. एंड दैट डे वी डिस्कस दिस टू पॉइंट्स, एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट दिस थ्री पॉइंट्स. वी टॉक्ड अबाउट प्रोबेबिलिटी थ्योरी एज अ टूल टू हैंडल अनसर्टेनिटी. देर आर अदर अप्रोच ऑल्सो, बट मेजरली वी यूज प्रोबेबिलिस्टिक मॉडल टू हैंडल अनसर्टेनिटी. Okay, so we have discussed its significance through various example, and we talked about its importance in decision theory. Then we studied different probability notations, starting with the sample space. So this is all set of all possible worlds, summation of probability of all possible world sums to one. Then two types of probability, that is prior probability and posterior probability, also known as conditional probability. Okay, so this is the probability of one event given that other event has already occurred. Okay, that is known as conditional probability, and we use this notation to denote that probability of A given B. Okay, so B is already happened. Now we are finding the probability of A given B has already occurred. And then we have seen this formula, probability of A given B equals to probability of A and B divided by probability of B. And from that we can derive the product rule. Okay, so remember this formula because we need this formula at many places. Then random variables, domain, set of all possible values known as domain. Then we talked about probability distribution. So here we have considered a case of single variable. So our variable is weather. Now it has four values: sunny, rain, cloudy and snow. Now every value of weather will occur with some probability. Okay, so we may have sunny weather with 0.6 probability, rain with 0.1, like that. Now the distribution of this probability is known as probability distribution. Okay, so this is the case of single variable, and we can denote that with this tuple also that we discussed that day. And if that variable is continuous one, then the probability distribution is governed by PDF, that is known as probability density function. And we know this formula, probability of negation of A equals to 1 minus probability of A, because the summation of all the event is 1, right? So if event is A, okay, other event will be not of A. Okay, so we know that, and we discuss this formula also, inclusion exclusion principle. Okay, so today we are going to study inference using full joint distribution. But first we'll discuss what is full joint distribution. Now in the previous class we talked about distribution of probability when we have single variable. But what if we have multiple variables? Okay, so consider the example. Here we have two variables, weather and cavity. Okay, cavity is related to that tooth एक पेशेंट एग्जाम्पल. ओके, सो ही मे हैव कैविटी और नो कैविटी. ओके, हियर आवर नोटेशन इज, सो वेदर एंड कैविटी आर द वेरिएबल्स. ओके, सो वी आर यूजिंग कैपिटल लेटर्स टू इंडिकेट वेरिएबल्स, एंड द कॉन्स्टेंट्स आर डिनोटेड इन स्मॉल लेटर्स. ओके, सो यू रिमेंबर दैट नोटेशन दैट वी आर यूजिंग. सो वेदर इज हैविंग फोर वैल्यूज एंड कैविटी इज हैविंग टू वैल्यूज. ओके, now what are the possible combination of these two variables? Okay, so we have to consider weather and cavity. Now total 8 combinations are possible. Okay, so we want to find distribution over these two variables. So in one of the instance we may have sunny weather with cavity, other second one will be sunny with no cavity. Similarly, rain with cavity, rain with no cavity. Okay, so 4 multiplied by 2, that is 8 combinations are possible. Okay, so every possible world will have some probability. okay, some possible world will be more probable, okay, its probability will be more. So this is known as joint probability. So when you have multiple variables, okay, so probability distribution over multiple variable is known as joint probability, okay, and if you enlist all the possible world, then it becomes full joint probability distribution, okay. So this is a table showing full joint probability distribution of these two variables, okay. So it is obvious that these two variables are independent variable, weather does not affect cavity, right? For an example, okay, so we will have total 8 possible worlds, okay. We can discuss one example. So here weather equals to sunny and cavity equals to true, okay. So and it will be according to our product rule. So it will be probability of weather equals to sunny given cavity equals to true into cavity equals to true, okay. So recall our product formula, okay. So whatever is given, you have to multiply by probability of that, okay. So here the given part is cavity equals to true, we have multiplied by cavity equals to true, okay. And it can be written in a single equation like this. Now notice here we have used capitals, okay. So now these capitals will be replaced by individual values, okay. Then we will get this 8 entry table. So I think the concept of full joint distribution is clear to you, okay. So when multiple variables are involved, then we have to consider joint distribution. Now here we are trying to study the method of probabilistic inference, okay. So how to infer a new fact in case of uncertainty, okay. So when you infer a new fact, now that fact will have some probability because uncertainty is there, okay. Given data itself has a probability, so that inferred fact will also have the derived probability. Now here we have considered instance where we have three variables. So we have toothache, okay. So toothache has two values, toothache, no toothache. Cavity also has two values, cavity, no cavity, and there is third variable called catch, okay. So what was the meaning of this variable? This is very strange variable defined in the textbook. Yes, catch variable. The dentist nasty steel probe catches in my mouth, my tooth, okay. So very strange variable, okay. So just consider its values, it is catch and no catch, okay. So what is the meaning of catch variable? The dentist nasty steel probe catches in my tooth, okay, while doing the treatment, okay. So now this table is depicting the full joint distribution of this example, okay. So this is a full joint distribution of these three variables, okay, toothache, okay. So notice capital T, capital C and capital C, okay, and these are the values. So toothache is having two values, cavity is having two values and catch is having two values. So total 8 entries are there, okay. So those 8 entries are shown in this table, okay. So this is our full joint distribution. Now how to infer the probability of new fact? Now our new proposition is cavity or toothache. Now what is the probability of cavity with toothache, okay, and we have or, okay. So we can have only cavity, only toothache, or both. Now we can use this probability distribution to find the probability of this event, okay. So cavity is true, so for this entire row cavity is true, okay. So you add these probabilities and then toothache should be true, okay. So for this 4 we have toothache as true. Let me clear this area, okay. So here we want to find the probability of cavity or toothache. Now there are 6 possible worlds where we have these two events as true, So for this row, cavity is true, and next is toothache. So for this four possible world, toothache is true. Okay. Now for these two possible world, both are true. Okay. So don't add them twice. Okay. Consider only once. Okay. And if you add these probabilities, you will get the probability of this event. Okay. So this is how you can determine the probability of any proposition. But the requirement is that you need a full joint distribution of that environment. Now next is how to compute conditional probabilities. Okay, so there you can use our product rule. So my new proposition is probability of cavity given toothache. Okay, so it will be apply the formula. So probability of cavity and toothache divided by probability of toothache, right? And you put the values. These are given in our table. So probability of toothache, so it would be, so toothache is true for these four possible worlds. Okay, so you do the addition of this, and next we want probability of cavity and toothache. So it would be cavity and toothache. So this means this. Okay, we want cavity and toothache. So cavity and toothache. So this would be this value, these two values. Okay, because toothache is true for this, right, and cavity. So this is the intersection of that. So these two values divided by these four values, and this is the probability of this event. And if we want probability of no cavity given toothache, okay, so no cavity, and see the denominator remains same. Okay, and we want probability of no cavity and toothache. Okay, so refer here. Okay, so toothache is true in this portion and no cavity, that means this bottom part. Okay, so you do the addition of that. Okay, and obviously the summation of these two event must be one, and we have got that. Okay, now one thing to notice is so in order to reduce the computation complexity, we can find this denominator only once. Okay, because this is repeated in both the calculations. So for that we have a concept called normalization. So in such cases, so if I want to find a probability distribution of this event, so notice here capital C is there. Okay, so capital this cavity has two values, cavity and no cavity. So there the denominator will be same, right? So what we can do, we will ignore that denominator part and let us replace it with alpha value. This is known as normalization constant. So this, the term 1 divided by probability of toothache, okay, that means the denominator part, 1 divided by p probability of toothache, that is known as normalization constant. Okay, and we will postpone that calculation of alpha value. Okay, we will postpone it, and we will find the probability, and at the last what we will do, the summation should be 1, right? So we will normalize it. Okay, so these are the probabilities without the denominators. Okay, and we know the normalization formula. Okay, so this first value has to be divided by 0.12 plus 0.08. okay, and similarly second term will be divided by this term. What we want the percentage of first value. Okay, it has 60% weightage and second one has 40% weightage. Okay, so I think you are familiar with normalization concept, right? We have done normalization in machine learning also, right? Okay, so what we have to do, we are postponing the calculation of a denominator, and at last we are doing the normalization. And what is the process of normalization? You divide each term by the summation of all terms. Okay, and this is how we can save the computation, and it makes computation easier. Next concept is known as independence. Okay, we talked about it in the last class. So consider we have two events A and B, and they are independent of each other. So the conditional probability becomes like this. So the meaning of this statement is probability of A given B. So B is already occurred. Now as they are independent of each other, so it would be probability of A only, because P is not affecting A, right? Okay, so now that changes our product rule formula. Okay, so when you have independent event, our product rule becomes this one. Okay, and where this independence is useful, so consider one example, and here we have added weather variable in our previous example. Okay, so in previous example we talked about these three variables, right? And there were 8 possible worlds. Now we have added toothache is having 4 values. Okay, so 8 multiplied by 4, now there are 32 possible worlds. Now how to determine? So now our aim is to find full joint distribution. Now how to find 32 values? Okay, so this is very difficult task. So to find probability distribution over this 4 values, so how to find that? So there we can use this independence concept. So we know that weather variable is independent of these 3 variables. This catch, cavity and toothache are related. Okay, they are related to that patient, but weather is independent variable. So we are going to use that. So probability of this event, so toothache, catch, cavity and cloudy. Okay, so we have cloudy weather. Now probability of this instance would be what? Okay, so we can use our product rule. So probably it will become probability of cloudy given toothache, catch and cavity. Okay, so this is my denominator. We have to multiply the probability by its probability. Okay, now we know that cloud and this values are independent, so this value would be equals to probability of cloudy. Okay, and this is how, and we are known with probability of cloudy, and this was already there. Okay, we had that table, this one. Okay, so now it becomes very easy to find out these 32 values. Okay, so this is the figure depicting that concept. So we have these 4 variables. Okay, and we were knowing the probability of weather, probability distribution of weather variable and probability distribution of these 3 variables. Okay, so now what happens? So this 32 table entry, 32 element table of 4 variables can be constructed from 1 8 element table and 1 4 element table. Okay, so this is how you can split the work. And based on this concept, we have Bayes rule. Okay, so when you have 2 independent events, okay, so this product rule can be modified. These are 2 forms of product rule. So P A and B equals to probability of A given B into probability of B. Okay, similarly we can replace A with B as AND is commutative, right? So it becomes probability of B given A into probability of A. Okay, and as LHS of 2 equations are equal, okay, so you can equate that and you will get this equation, and this is known as Bayes rule. Okay, so this is very trivial formula, but it is very useful. So this example explains the significance of that formula. Okay, so some facts will be known and some facts will be unknown. Okay, so by using this Bayes rule we can determine that unknown rules. Okay, so here what we have, so we want to find the probability of symptoms given disease. Actually we want to derive probability of disease given symptoms. Okay, so if disease is given, then doctor knows the symptoms, right? But reverse is not true. Okay, from the symptoms he cannot determine the disease, because same symptoms will be there for several diseases, right? So this is exactly, we cannot derive the probability of disease given symptoms, but this is known. Given a disease, he knows all the symptoms. Okay, so now if we have a data, so For example, a doctor knows that this disease causes patient to have stiff neck 70% of the time. Okay, so for that disease, the symptoms is 0.7. Okay, the probability is 0.7. We know the probability of that disease. Okay, so out of 50,000 patient, one person will have that disease. Okay, so this is the probability of that disease. And symptoms, okay, so and symptoms probability, yes, the prior probability of any patient having a stiff neck is 1%. Okay, so other probabilities are known. By using a Bayes rule, we can determine the probability of that disease given the symptoms. Okay, and it comes out to be this one. Okay, so if 14 divided by, so if I move that point here, so it would be 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros. You simplify this, so division by 2, so it becomes 5000. Okay, so this is nearly equals to, so in the numerator we have 7, so 7 divided by nearly equals to 4900. Okay, can I say like this? Okay, and now we can divide this, so it comes out to be 1/700. Now what is the meaning of this? So out of 700 people, okay, one will have that disease. So we expect less than 1 in 700 patient with stiff neck to have meningitis disease. Okay, so this is how Bayes rule will be helpful in certain situation. Okay, so in tomorrow's lecture we will discuss Wampus world. Okay, so now here our agent will be probabilistic agent. Okay, in the last class, in the last unit, our agent was logical agent. Okay, he used to derive the fact based on inference rule. Okay, now here he will derive the probability of the room having the pit. Okay, so he will tell this room will have pit with this much probability. Okay, based on the given data. So we'll stop today. Any doubt? I think the full joint distribution concept is clear to you. Okay, so for inference you should have a joint distribution. Okay, and then we can apply this rules, inference rule, to derive the probability of new fact. And mostly we are using the product rule. And we have seen sometimes independence rules also helps. And Bayes rule is there.